I see you gather before me. Hungry, terrified, clutching your babes to your breast. Emperor Emir has marched his legions into our lands, laid siege to every fortress from here to the Blue Mountains. Rabid and ravenous, he bites and bites away. Men of the North! You stand at the precipice. Your kings have failed you, so now you turn to the gods. And yet you do not plead. You do not kneel to dust your heads with ash. Instead, you wail, why have the gods forsaken us? We must look into the trials we failed long ago. In a time past, our world intertwined with another through an upheaval scholars call the conjunction of the spheres. The gods allowed unholy forces to slip into our domain. The offspring of that cataclysm was the nefarious force called magic. Yet we did not banish it, instead studying the vile arcane for our own power and wealth. And the monsters at our door, the unholy relics of this conjunction. The trolls, the corpse-eaters, the werewolves. Did we raise our swords against them? Or have we laid this burden on others? On so-called witches. Stray children taught the ways of foul sorcery, their bodies mutated through blasphemous ritual. Sent to fight monsters, though they could not distinguish good from evil. The flicker of humanity, long extinguished within them. Yes, their numbers have dwindled through the years. But a few still roam our lands, offering their bloody work for coin. To this day, they shame us with their very existence. The North bleeds, flogged by war. The battles are the gods' whip, chastisement for our sins. And let us not forget the terrors, the scourges from beyond our world. The Wild Hunt rides the sky with every full moon. The Dark Raiders abduct our children into lands unknown. Some say they herald a second conjunction. Can we chart a course back into the light? Will we find the strength to banish the mages from our kingdoms? Unite around the warmth of the eternal fire. Nigh is the time of the sword and axe. None will fight this war in our stead. Nigh is the time of madness and disdain.
Thank you. don't find that amusing.
It wasn't meant to amuse, but to prod you to hurry. It's midday already. You promised Ciri you'd train with her. Go before Vesemir bores her to death with those etchings.
So, later then.
See you later.
You're running out of juice.
I know. You might bring me some more once you're done training.
Nothing but silver.
Gold clashes with my complexion. You should know that.
Lilac and gooseberries, of course.
Geralt, stop fingering my toiletries.
See, I thought Ciri could stand to wait a little longer.
It's uninstructive. Not to mention unreasonable.
I don't want to be reasonable.
Aha, so that's the way the wind blows. Go and train with her, then come back. It'll give me a chance to put my face on.
Of all the women I've known, you're the only one who does that before.
You've known many.
What's it matter? Only ever thought of you. Got any clothes that aren't black or white?
Undergarments. Isn't there... Yes? Yes? Not now. Ciri awaits. Thank you.
old Witcher's fast asleep. Ciri's disappeared somewhere, of course. Guess she prefers practice to theory.
What?
Time to wake up, Master. These lessons so boring they put you to sleep too?
Damn it. After taking notes on ghouls and owl ghouls, wanted to rest my eyes a bit.
Making her slog through that brick? No wonder she took off.
John of Bruges lacks flair, true, but he's reliable. Not like the hogwash they print nowadays. She's tackling the pendulums, right? How many times do I have to tell her? Don't train alone. It only embeds your errors. Bring our young damsel to the lower courtyard. She wants to practice, she'll get to practice.
Gotta admit, we've spoiled her.
We've spoiled her. I've been saying it from the start. Ciri needs a firm hand.
Been saying that true. You let her walk all over you just like the rest of us do.
Fine. I suppose I'm partly to blame. But this has to end. Now. Killing monsters is not something to be taken lightly. Ciri must understand that if she's to become one of us. I'll see you below.
See why you were so eager to practice. Strike! You're not in the circus, pirouette. Wrong. Footwork. Get down.
With a flip?
What do you think? All right. Take off the blindfold. You've got work to do. Your reflexes are still slow.
Maybe for a Witcher.
Think drowners or striggers will go easy on you because you haven't undergone the mutations? Though in your shoes, I'd fear Vesemir more than any strigger. Disobeying his instructions? Unwise.
Well, yes, but that book was horribly dull.
I know, and you know that's no excuse.
I'm sorry. It won't happen again.
Sorry's not good enough. You're gonna read Ghouls and Owl Ghouls in its entirety, appendices included.
No, please! I'd rather clean the stables!
End of discussion. Come on, we'll practice with the others down below.
Shall we run the walls?
Of course. Is a Witcher school or an elven bathhouse?
Beat you to the bottom.
Maybe if you fall. What did I tell you about breathing? Through your mouth, in rhythm with your steps. Ciri, cut it out.
Ow!
win.
Your legs are longer. I'll show you yet. Just need to grow a bit. Oh no. Vesemir's got that look.
Anything to say for yourself, young lady?
I'm very sorry, Uncle Vesemir.
Young blood craves action, I understand that. But when you fight a beast, knowledge counts as much as your silver sword. At the very least, you ought to be able to tell a ghoul from an owl ghoul.
By markings, like unto the panthera tigris that in Zeracania dwells, and by the sickly paleness of its visage.
So you did. Read the chapter. Still, you should have asked if...
But you were asleep, Uncle Vesemir.
Don't try to weasel your way out of this.
A witcher must know how to trick his opponent. You said so yourself.
Might have. But don't use my words of wisdom on Vesemir, got it? That's playing with fire.
Fine, we've talked enough. Geralt, you're with me, Lambert with Eskel, Ciri with the dummy.
Again?
Stop groaning and grab a sword. What do you think? Should we start by reviewing the fundamentals or go right to free training?
Should work on the basics. Even skilled masters need to hone the fundamentals, and Ciri's barely a novice.
Draw your sword, Geralt! One, two, three. Strong strikes now. Give it all you got. Never lock your elbow when striking, young lady.
Had enough.
Dodge.
Position, Ciri. Footwork. Remember.
Ciri, see how Geralt holds his sword, its angle.
Damn it!
Stop showing off, Geralt.
What am I supposed to parry? I'm fighting a stupid dummy.
Pretend now, live later. Riposte! Strike! Counter-strike! Next!
Slightly spectacular!
Now, young lady, bring the day to a close, we'll go over a few witches' signs. Let's start with Quen.
What now?
Ciri, Quen is sometimes called the witch's shield. Now watch carefully to see why. The Shast Igni, Geralt. I want to see sparks fly. See? If
it not for the Quen sign, I'd be aflame by now. All right, Geralt, come on! See that, Ciri? Ard will knock anyone or anything off balance. Destroy their... Time for Axie. Damn it. I hate this feeling. Axie can really muddle your mind. Erden now. Show her, Geralt.
Enough.
See this, Ciri? Couldn't move if I wanted to. Throw a bomb. Don't worry, Ciri. Quen will dampen the blow. Fine. Enough. Continue training at will.
Time to answer this.
I'm too old for this shit.
You really showed him, kid.
Ciri, get down here.
A little she-devil. Soon as she's back, we'll set her to polishing all the swords at Kaer Morhen.
Find that helmet. Ciri? Make sure to find every last blade for you. What the?
You all right?
Had a nightmare.
About?
Take forever to explain.
Dawn, some way off. We've got time.
Started in the guest room at Kaer Morhen. I was relaxing in a tub, and next to me...
Triss?
Yennefer. Funny, isn't it? She's never been there. Seemed so real in my dream, though.
Was she nagging you about something?
True to life, indeed. We'll find her.
In the dream, I went and found Ciri. Then we trained.
Those were the days. Little she-devil. I've trained kids who were faster, stronger, but none had her character. Didn't end well, did it, your dream?
No. The Wild Hunt appeared, attacked Ciri. I couldn't move, stood there like a stump.
It was just a dream.
That's the problem. It was more. In the past, when Ciri'd appear in my dreams, something was wrong. She was in danger.
We taught her how to defend herself from anything, wraiths included.
That's the problem. It was more. In the past, when Ciri'd appear in my dreams, something was wrong.
We taught her how to defend herself from anything, wraiths included.
Be dawning soon. Time to go.
Wait. Show me the letter from Yennefer. Might have overlooked some hint in there.
Didn't overlook anything. We were meant to meet in Willoughby. That's what she wrote. Meanwhile, one army or another burned the village to the ground. All we can do is follow her trail, so...
Stop talking for a minute and give me the letter. How about that? It does smell of lilac and gooseberries.
You were gonna read it, not sniff it.
We must meet. Soon. Willoughby near Vizima. Nothing else to guide us there. What's this postscript? I still have the unicorn?
Stuffed unicorn. Used it once or twice. In certain situations.
The things young folk get up to these days.
Back on topic. How's it look? How far behind Yennefer are we?
2 or 3 days. Trail's fresh. But it looks like it leads towards the main road. Could be muddled there. Wait, hear that?
I hear it. I smell it. Ghouls.
Pass necrophages. Let's go before any more show up. Thank you.
Ever tell you about this sorcerer I knew? Couldn't stop talking about how useful they are as creatures.
Where do you think you're going? Come back!
Because you can brew potions from their blood?
No. Because by eating rotting corpses, they prevent epidemics.
Where do you think you're going? Come back!
Did he know they eat the living as well?
No. Really upset him, too. His theory collapsed.
It's not exactly going our way.
We have a side.
The Northern Realms.
Radovid's realms, don't you mean? Temeria and Edirne are no more.
Radovid's pledged to restore the old borders as soon as he wins the war.
Believe that?
Gotta believe something. It's what keeps us going.
What do you want? What do you want?
Has it gone?
Yeah. Come out.
Gods, that was close. I was sure I'd end up like my mare.
Provided you got lucky.
Your horse died quickly, but griffins like to toy with their prey. Eat it, alive, piece by piece.
Oh. You'd like a reward, I suppose.
You don't owe us anything. You were in need. We helped.
And they call witches heartless. Say they won't lift a finger without pay.
They also say mice are born of rotting straw. Back to the trail.
Like I said, leads to the main road and ends there, muddled.
You seek someone?
Yes, a woman. Medium height, long black hair. Seen anyone like that?
No, but there's an inn here in White Orchard. Sole one around. Gets its share of travelers. Perhaps you'll learn something there? Besides, the innkeep's my cousin. Tell her Bram sent you. She'll treat you like family.
Not a bad idea. Especially since that wound needs cleaning.
Ah, beast barely grazed me. But sure, could use a good rye. Nice and cool, you know, straight from a cellar.
Let's go.
Greetings.
So, a griffin this close to the village? Strange.
My thoughts exactly. In the forest or the mountains, sure, but here? Near the main road.
Maybe it's the war. Corpses everywhere, the stench of blood, burnt flesh. Drives monsters crazy sometimes.
Men, too. We need to watch ourselves in White Orchard. And we should leave as soon as we learn anything.
Move it!
Come on now.
Look at the trouble.
Whoa!
Oh, so it worked. Set to be still drowned. Witcher!
What? Take that down before there's trouble.
That is a coat of arms, the Temerian lilies. They've a right to hang there.
This ain't Temeria no more, old man. It's Nilfgaard now.
My arse it is.
Witches.
I'll not drink with Weaver Lost freaks.
Beg your pardon for those thugs.
No need. We're used to it.
Folk are jumpy around here. Armies just passed through. Now a griffin's prowling about.
Mm-hmm. Already had the pleasure. Ran into your kinsman, Bram.
Bram? How is he?
Alive. Sends his regards.
Master witches. Food and drink on the house. What can I get you?
Looking for a woman. Raven-haired, violet eyes. Dresses in black and white. Riding in from Willoughby. And, strange as it sounds, lilac and gooseberries might have smelled that.
I've not seen nor smelt such a lady. Believe I'd remember.
Yeah, especially hard to forget this one.
Plenty of travellers about, though. Folk from all over. Might be worth your while to ask after her.
Show me what you got behind the counter. Pretty busy place you got.
Nations on the move. Some search for kin, others just want to get out of the way of the armies. They all need food, drink, and a night's rest and warmth.
So, war's been good for your trade?
Aye, so far. But it'd be best to know peace again. Times like these, you never know what tomorrow will bring.
There a contract on that griffin?
Nay, not at the moment. Used to be. Soon as a beast had built a nest nearby, the alderman would start a collection, or go to the Lord for help. Now the alderman don't use the privy without asking the Black One's permission first. And it seems they hanged the Lord. So no contract.
Shame. We might have done something, but not for free.
Thanks for everything. Help you bandage that up?
Please. I'm not decrepit yet.
Then I'll ask about Yennefer.
Just remember, we'd rather not draw any attention.
Here. Black One's been out measuring the fields.
Let him measure. Better that than burning the harvest.
Oh, Drommel. Drommel, you're dumber than...
Yes? What is it, Wolf?
Realize it's been half a year since we hunted down that fiend in Varun?
Yes. Well, that was more than a fiend. What was that bastard's name? Drugan? May the soil lie light upon him. Things used to be simpler. Monsters were bad, humans good. Now, everything's all confused.
Used to be exactly the same. You've just forgotten.
Do well not to point up my age. You're near a century old yourself.
See you later, Vesemir. I'm looking for someone.
And we seek some peace and quiet.
Out of my face, freak, for your breath sours my beer.
Raven, a woman dressed in black and white. Seen her? Talk.
Folks say the lady rode through the village a few days back. Galloping so fast she knocked Radabor into a ditch.
Which way did she go?
Dunno. Lots of tracks leading off the main road. Could have gone anywhere.
Oi, people! The freak's taken Micah's mind!
And I'll take your tongue if you don't shut up.
Oh, I've drunk enough. My head's spinning.
Take the hooch. It's wizardry.
Once more, there are four factions.
Four what?
Factions, teams, suits, similar to clubs and spades, except each suit has its own face cards. There are also special cards.
Wouldn't you rather play war? It's like to be near dawn before you get your game in, Minoggin.
What a waste of time. The Earth shall revolve around the sun before you comprehend these rules.
Got a minute?
Why not? Aldert Geert, Assistant Professor in Contemporary History at Oxenfurt Academy.
Geralt of Rivia, Witcher, with tenure. I'm looking for a woman. Long hair, dressed in black and white. Seen anyone like that?
Of course not. Unlike the populace, I know the horsewoman of war is pure poppycock.
Horsewoman of war? What's that about?
Folks say an omen. A beautiful phantom rides the fields at night, looks as you described her. Armies follow her, and all who cross her path meet with misfortune.
I can vouch for the last bit. Know where they saw her?
No, facts interest me, not fairy tales.
Not a place I'd ever expect to find a scholar. Take it you're fleeing the war?
Quite the opposite. Chasing it. I'm headed for the front.
Tired of life?
I seek knowledge, which I value more than life itself. I've a thirst no dusty old tomes can quench. I wish to see the Nilfgaardian invasion with my own eyes, understand it, and record it all in my chronicle, my magnum opus.
Interesting. We need somebody to describe war, what it's really like. Not colorful banners and generals making moving speeches, but rape, violence, and thoughtless cruelty.
Ah, I see you lack the polish of the Academy. Rape and cruelty are details of no import to the war's course. Trinkets on the garment of conflict, one might say.
Tell that to the people whose houses burned down. War reached Novigrad yet?
Nope, but it's only a matter of time. Nilfgaard on one bank, Redania on the other. Drooling over the city like dogs over a juicy bone.
Many a ruler's choked on that bone.
True. We value our liberty in Novigrad, and we know how to fight for it.
The scholars especially.
The sword is not the only weapon. Do not forget, architects from our academy designed the city walls. Walls no war machine has ever crumbled.
Gotta go. So long.
A moment, Witcher. You strike me as a man of the world. Are you familiar with Gwent?
No, and I don't have time to learn.
But the rules are quite simple. Come, let's play.
Why not?
Splendid! Here's how it's done.
Thank you.
Well, you've a knack for this game. If you ever find yourself in Oxenfurt and wish to play a true master, ask for Stepan. A simple innkeep by trade, but a true maestro when it comes to Gwent.
I'll remember that. Thanks. Looking for a woman.
Like everyone.
Not like everyone. And not just any woman. Mine smells of lilac and gooseberries, dresses in black and white.
Two schnappsies? It'll lift your spirits.
Fine, I'll have a drink. Can we cut to the chase? You seen her or not?
Yennefer of Vengerberg.
Never mentioned her name.
Yet you described her perfectly. And once I hear something, I never forget. Can't help it.
How do you know Yennefer?
What a question. Master Dandelion's ballads, of course. The only way a humble merchant might hope to rub up against greatness. Unless, that is, he's as lucky as I am.
And runs into a very patient witcher.
It's a Geralt of Rivia himself, the Butcher of Blaviken.
You seen Yennefer?
Deepest apologies, but I must ask. Is this about love?
Guessed it. It's love.
I knew it at once.
What do you know? Tell me.
Before you appeared, it never occurred to me that might have been Yennefer. Who would have thought?
Get to the point.
An Ilfgaardian scout from the local garrison saw her.
Where?
At their camp. She rode in there. Dark of night. Black and white. Gooseberries and... Yes, I know. Had a terse exchange with the garrison commander and raced off.
Where to?
I'm not omniscient. Ask at the garrison.
Thanks.
We men of the road must stick together. Perhaps one day I'll be in trouble, and you'll be nearby to help.
Yes? What is it, Wolf?
See you later, Vesemir.
Done drinking?
Mm-hmm.
Then fuck off!
Don't want your kind here.
Wouldn't want to stay long anyway.
Maybe not. And maybe you'll just stay forever.
6 feet under.
Test day, no griffin would fly around for long. Having a call for the answer straight away. Toss and point at him, problem solved.
Something else you'll be needing.
No Nilfgaardian rule to your liking?
What's there to like? It is the same as any other. They tax us, requisition this or that. But they do keep the peace in the village, I'll grant them that.
You don't mourn Temeria's passing?
I mourned it round half a year back, when King Foltes was cut down. Now I just want peace.
Farewell.
The Grand told me about Smith's. Lad went missing one day, so folk found a witch that was hunting nearby. Started poking past him, and he started twisting.
Come on now.
Now, D-E-R-V-A-L, not Voidemort.
It's raining and pouring, and Vermeer's roaring. He bumped his head and he went to bed and wet himself the morning.
Nilfgaard,
what did you say? Who taught you that?
Chitty.
Then by my leave. Gold Sun guide you far away from my land.
Never to sing that rhyme again. Never. And you're not to play it.
But Chetty's my best mate!
Chetty's a little fool.
What happened here?
Oh, got a wee bit chilly the night, so I set fire to my forge. Got it nice and roaring. Roasted some wieners. What do you think happened, dimwit? Some bugger set alight me workshop. I've lost everything. Everything!
Sorry. Any suspects?
Whole damned village. I've lived here half a century. Thought they saw me as one of their own. But everything changed when the Black Ones came. I'm the only smith around, so I got to service their garrison. bang dents out of plate, shoe horses. That sort of thing. Nilfgaardians don't pay me a bloody copper. Just give me supplies and orders. But humans can't fathom that. They think I'm getting rich off their misfortune. That I sleep on a pile of gold like a ploughing dragon. They've stopped talking to me. Spit when I pass. And now this.
I can find your arsonist, provided you're willing to pay.
I've not much left, but I'll give you all if you bring me that horse in, so that he gets what he deserves. The night of the fire, I heard movement outside my hut. Went out to see if I could find any tracks. I found nothing. But then I haven't got cat eyes, have I? Good luck.
Don't you look at me.
From a tinderbox. Arsonist must have lit his torch here, tossed it on the roof, then fled through the orchard. Shavings from a tinderbox. Arsonist must have lit his torch here, tossed it on the roof, then fled through the orchard. Took off his boots and went in the water. Probably wanted to cover his trail.
Well, Jeff? Step away.
Decide. Should we draw it or no? Gotta make soup out.
Lost his boots in the rush.
He said he'd not give his dog this water. Not with so many corpses rotting in. It's sure to be poison.
Sure.
Lost his boots in the rush.
Will you go to the well in Hovel instead?
Not on your life.
I don't like you, Wild One.
Watch it. Ours is a decent village.
Lost his boots in the rush. Something jumped out of the rushes. Drowners. But he managed to escape.
Started poking him, asking. When he started twisting and squirming, so wham bam, they knocked his head off.
Freak.
So it worked.
Trail ends here, but I'll recognize him by his wounds. Drowner claw marks. It's gotta be him. Nasty wound. Run into a drowner?
What the fuck do you care?
Whoa, our arsonist's a charmer too. Come on, Smith wants to talk to you.
I not talk to a non-human. Sons of bitches all, and dwarves are the worst. Greedy little magpies do anything for gold, they will. They forge the blades the black ones put to our throats, am I not right? Listen, we can work this out, man to man. I give you gold, you don't turn me in. My mum died a while back and I sold her tools. I've spent some, but what's left is yours.
Magpies and dwarves might be greedy, but I'm not. Can't buy me.
Then I'll beat your fucking mug to a pulp!
Try me, peasant. I could use the practice.
Shit. Stop, I give up. Damn it. You broke my nose.
But not your legs, so let's go see the smith. And take my advice. Don't try anything else. Here you go. One village pyromaniac in the flesh.
Nap! You! I knew your mom for years. Charged her nearly a copper. This is how you repay me. I've had enough. Hey, soldier. A minute of your time, please.
No! Willis, I beg you. I was drunk. Didn't know what I was doing.
I've told you, Master Willis. We will help you rebuild once reinforcements come. The supplies have been ordered.
Not what this is about, mate. This here's the arsonist. A witcher found him.
The forge was important to the garrison. Destroying it was sabotage. No trial needed here. Just a tree.
Harsh as punishment goes.
But deserved. You know, I hated the Black Ones at first, like everybody else did. Now I'm thinking they might just bring order to this place. Teach these layabouts some manners. But enough about that. Your reward. And I managed to save some things from the fire. Anvil still holds, so I'm sure I can bang something out on it. You need anything, let me know. Give you a good price. A return customer. Welcome. What can I do for you this time?
Show me what you got. I'd like you to forge something for me. So long.
I think those plums are wreaking havoc on my gut.
It's raining, it's pouring, and Bromir's snoring. He bumped his head when he went to bed and wet himself the morning.
Chitty!
Now listen carefully. You're never to sing that rhyme again. Never. And you're not to play with Chitty.
Chitty's my
boy! Bipe-eyed Hellraiser.
You'll regret it.
It's Dervin now. D-E-R.
Looking for trouble.
Your gran told me about Smithfield. Lad went missing one day, so folk had him dishonored.
Let's go!
Wouldn't mind you, sir. We'll look for Bastion later, once it's safe.
Do that often? Talk to your dog?
It's my brother's, Bastion's. But I guess he's mine now. See, Bastion fought the Black Ones in a battle just outside the village. Haven't had word of him since. I told him, do like I did, lose a finger or two so they won't recruit you. Too damn afeard he was. Bloody hell.
I'd walk the battlefield if I were you.
I did. A sea of corpses. And corpses feeding. Someone told me they're afeard of fire, so I took a torch, tried to chase them off. Horse shite, I tell you. Would have ended up eaten alive if it weren't for Hussar here. Listen, guessing you carry those swords for more than show. Come with me. Keep the ghouls off. Help me find Bastion and I'll pay you well.
Fine, I'll help you. Just been a few days since the battle. Chances we find your brother alive are slim. Very slim.
Who would have thought? But I want to find his body at least. So Bastion don't rot there in the sun with the Black Ones. Meet me on the hill, overlooking the battlefield. We'll move on together from there.
corpses. And the war's just started.
You're here, good. Bastion. His body must be here somewhere.
Among countless others. Want to examine them one by one? Could take a while.
You needn't fret. The recruits from White Orchard painted a small flower on their shields so as to be able to spot each other in battle. There was just a few of them. We look for the flowers, we'll find Bastion quick.
No offense, but many a soldier's dropped his shield, especially if he was on the losing side.
If we find the shield alone, Hassar will catch the scent and lead us to Bastion. Come on. Sooner we get this done, the better. Alive. Stop running like a scalded cat. Help me.
That him?
No. Vapor's son.
That him?
No. Come on, Hassar. Can you smell Bastion, boy? Still nothing. Come on, Hassar. Can you smell Bastion, boy? Still nothing.
That him?
No. Doesn't look anything like him. Come on, Hassar. Can you smell Bastion, boy? Still nothing.
Skin's burned off. Might be hard to tell, I know, but... this be him?
I am. Bastion was big, broad-shouldered. This one seems smaller, but maybe it's the fire did that.
He found him! Hassar's caught his scent! Come on!
But there is more. My lieutenant demanded we defecate on command. Ballista bolts, landing all around, and all he could say was, "A soldier with a full stomach will not step onto the battlefield." Now shit, that is an order. Can you believe it? The cretin.
Stop! You're killing me. My ribs. It hurts to laugh.
That needs a tourniquet. But first, want to explain what's going on here?
Bastion! Is he... Has this Nilfgaardian captured you?
No. He saved my life. I got a cut to me side. And then got hit in the head. Couldn't see anything. Rosin here found me as he crawled across the battlefield. His legs twisted. And so we were. A blind man leading a cripple. Found this place.
I'm taking you home. We need to see to these wounds.
I won't leave Rosin here. Alone he'll die. And he can't go back to his home. He's deserted. They'll hang him.
And what if they find him with us? They'll hang us all, my Laisha included. No, the Blacken stays here.
Bastion only made it with the Black One's help. Maybe you ought to show him Nordlings aren't as barbarous as Nilfgaardians make us out to be.
Well, I could give him our Pa's clothes, teach him to work the field, but that accent... Fine, I'll take him in. Thank you, Witcher. Your reward, and the gods protect you.
Let's go!
Take it easy. Humming. Place of power. It's gotta be. Ghoul nest. Ought to just destroy it.
Thank you.
nest. Ought to just destroy it. Come on. Faster. We meet again.
Thank you for saving me. People say all kinds of things about witches, but I've always known yours to be an honorable guild.
So you managed to salvage some goods?
Yes, but I await the repair of my wagon. As time passes, my losses grow. Do you need something? I'll let it go half free.
Let me have a look at your stock. Take care.
Barbarians.
A return customer. Welcome.
Show me what you got. So long.
A return customer.
Show me what you got. So long. Greetings, good man. Having trouble with your well? That's what I read.
Aye. 'Tis haunted. Has been for a good 20 years.
20? So why do you put out a notice just now?
'Cause earlier on we drew our water from the river. But so many corpses floating in it after the battle has turned noxious. My daughter Mandy drank half a pitcher. Felt dreadful ill. Can't keep nothing down. She grows worse by the day. Herbalist claims you fight a fever with drink. And not beer nor cider, but water. Clear, pure water. And where am I to get that if not from the well? But first, the ghost's got to be driven away. And don't let any man near.
This ghost. Describe it for me.
Well, it's awful frightening. Awful.
I meant, what does it look like?
It looks like a woman, but fresh from the grave. Wears a dirty dress, all rags, its skin flaking off its bones, and it howls like it's suffering.
Some wraith, or maybe an alp.
If you don't wallop it, Master, if you don't take care of it, that is, it'll come kill me daughter.
Fine, I'll help. Where's this well?
In Havel, a settlement on the heights. It's abandoned now, no one ventures there on account of the ghost being about. Drive it off. Please.
Well, strange. No sign of a ghost. Maybe it only shows at a certain time of day. Grass around the well scorched. Thank you. body's dried to a crisp. Signs of burns. All signs
grass
point
around
to the well
way. Scorched.
Something's tied the Noonwraith to this place. An object. Something she needs before she'll leave this world. Useful. A man. Stabbed with a knife, died on the spot. Animals fed on his body, picked his skeleton clean. More blood stains over there. But it's not his blood. That bracelet might be what ties the woman's spirit to this place. Blood stains, barely visible. Someone was dragged this way. someone who was still alive. Palm prints in blood. Small hands. A woman's. Someone dragged her out. She was wounded. Fought for her life. No body in sight, but might still find some tracks. Under the right conditions, bloodstains can remain visible for decades. Another print by the well. Bloodstains. Almost faded. But the lines taut. Something's not right. A corpse, hanged by the bucket rope. Woman the journal belonged to. Must be. Wide pelvis, small jaw. A woman. Around 30, judging by the teeth. Left arm's missing. Need to cremate the remains. Gotta find the object that binds her to this place before I do, though. Was she wearing the bracelet from her husband? Might be why her arm fell off. Gotta jump down there. Hope I don't break my legs. Wide pelvis, small jaw. Need to cream. Was she wearing? Gotta jump. Not to come up empty-handed. A bracelet with an inscription. To Claire, from Volker. Bracelet must have belonged to the woman in the well. Lovely craftsmanship, but I'll have to burn it with the body to get rid of the noon wraith for good. Better do it near the well. Thank you. this fight. Brew some wraith oil, drink some potions. Bracelet. Igni. Igni. She's gone. For good. Job done. The well was haunted by the ghost of a woman who was killed there. I drove it away.
I just hope every unburied wretch don't start haunting us. Or that battlefield's gonna cause us a heap of trouble.
If they do, you know who to contact. Meanwhile, Claire, Volker, names ring a bell?
I don't know him. Though I did hear our herbalist Tamira mention a Claire once. Same one, maybe? Your reward, Master Witcher. The gold I'd hid away for Mandy's dowry. Without you, she'd never have lived to wed. Now, there's hope for it, at least.
At this point, doubt I'll ever marry. You keep the coin for Mandy, her wedding. Raise a toast to my health then.
Thank you, Master Witcher. Them's warm words, you've a good heart. But I can't let you go empty-handed. Take this, at least. Good luck.
Faster.
Move it! Let's go!
place of power, should draw from it. Of power.
Thank you. Oh.